In this video, I'm going to talk about my live streaming setup and why I feel the combo of the M1 Mac Mini and Ecamm Live make for a fantastic minimal live streaming setup. I'm Raphael and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up because a minimal, frictionless live streaming setup encourages going live more often. I had a goal to start live streaming this year, but I wanted to make sure that the process was as frictionless as possible, easy to repeat, and require the least amount of equipment, but still be able to achieve fantastic results. I initially started live streaming with my 2017 MacBook Pro and OBS, and I felt that it worked great, but there were a lot of steps needed for it to work well, and a lot of little things you needed to do to make a good looking stream. I recently got the M1 Mac Mini, and it's been great as a live streaming computer. I know I've been pretty tough on the M1 computers in the pro space, but this is one place that it does shine. Thus far, I've done several live streams with the Mac Mini and Ecamm, all while doing screen recording, doing a walkthrough in Final Cut Pro, having both Safari and Chrome open with tabs, streaming in ultra low latency at 24 frames a second with multiple cameras connected, with guests joining. It has been a great experience. And this is all before Ecamm Live became native on the M1 Max. So it's even better now. As a dedicated streaming computer, these are the things I love about the M1 Mac Mini over the MacBook Air and the MacBook Pro 13-inch. It has plenty of ports. It has two USB-C and two USB-A. Having the extra ports is really good because there are many peripherals that won't work into USB hubs, like the Blackmagic Ultra Studio recorder that I use. That has to be plugged in directly. On the M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch, you'd have to use one USB-C for the power and the other for the HDMI to USB, and you're kind of stuck at that point. But with the Mac Mini, you have four ports. I plug in two cameras, one through the Ultra Studio and the USR directly using the US web utility software. I use the Blackmagic Ultra Studio recorder because my camera has HDMI and SDI out. So I got it because it works better for my workflow. But you can just as easily use the Elgato Cam Link or the Atomos Connect 4K. These can be used with any camera that has a clean HDMI signal out. I use one of the USB ports for the Shure MV7 USB mic. I love how you can plug in the USB to the computer, but still have an XLR directly into the camera. So if you want to record on the camera and live stream, you can do both with independent outputs. I like this mic because Shure has an app where you can EQ the audio a bit for your talking style. I personally don't like having the mic too close. I like it a little bit further away. And the app has a preset for that, so you can actually have the mic a little bit further away from your mouth and it still sounds really good. And with all this plugged in, I can still plug in another camera directly with the Ultra Studio or Cam Link or with a USB directly from the camera. I use a 4K monitor with the HDMI port. Having a dedicated Ethernet port is amazing because doing live streams over Wi-Fi can be spotty at times. It's not really recommended either. One of the biggest non-technical benefits is that the M1 Mac Mini is super quiet, right beside the mic, like zero noise, which is a huge departure from the 15-inch MacBook Pro that I was using before that sounded like an airplane taking off when the fans kicked in. The Mac Mini is silent, even when I'm using the iPad with Sidecar to do interviews during the live streams. Recently, I was doing an editing demo on a live stream and the whole system remained silent and ran smooth the entire time, all while streaming, playing back, playing music, and recording the live stream session to the SSD. Ecamm Live as a streaming software, I really like. And I've tried StreamYard and I've used OBS in the past. And for a little context, about 5 years ago, I worked for a company which developed its own broadcast studio in a box, which was essentially a broadcast level computer and software combo that was able to stream peer-to-peer anywhere in the world with broadcast quality and reliability. It needed an operator and a powerful computer, and they spent years developing it. It worked very well and had some amazing features, but it was very complicated for most people. So when I set out to find which live streaming software I was going to use, there were features I knew I wanted. So when I tried Ecamm Live for the first time, and it was so intuitive with all the features it had built in, I was instantly hooked. What I like about Ecamm Live is the ease of use. No plugins to install, no stream keys to get. Schedule streams right from the app for YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitch. Or set it to a custom stream, or send it to Restream to go live to multiple locations. And if you have more than one camera, I love how you can switch camera sources just by clicking the source or by pressing the numbers on the keyboard. No A10 Mini or external camera switchers or controllers required. The software does so much. You can combine picture in picture on the fly, see your live stream comments, mark favorite comments, and come back to them later. You can add them to your stream, add overlays, add simple text on screen, share your screen or a specific app or PowerPoint, playback movies from your desktop just by dragging and dropping, control your audio sources on the fly, add sound effects. I also like how you can add music to your streams by either adding it to the sound effects, or the way I do it is I use Stream Beats from Harris Heller and play them right from Apple Music or Spotify. I like using iTunes specifically because it has a built-in equalizer and I bring down the mids so my voice can cut through during the live stream. With Ecamm, you can also invite multiple people to your streams very easily through Skype or in the pro version with an interview link. And this process is very frictionless on the interviewee side. It opens up in a Chrome page, asks for access to the camera and mic, and they're even able to share their desktop if they wanted to. For some of the best results, I set up an iPad with a teleprompter and use it as an extra screen so I can be looking directly at the camera while talking to the guest. And the whole interaction just feels very natural. And also in the pro version, this is one of my favorite things, you can add LUTs to all your camera sources, which was something that I was really struggling to get right in all the other services. Personally, adding LUTs was a big feature for me because it means I don't have to switch too many of my camera settings and just apply a LUT with my personal look and feel so the streams look like my color graded videos. The whole app feels like drag and drop simple, and you can arrange the windows that best suit your need. You can use any camera as a source, your webcam, your iPhone, as long as you can get the signal into your computer, Ecamm will recognize it. And it's completely up to you if you want to use more sources. And like I said earlier, the latest update of Ecamm is optimized for the M1 chip, and it's a beauty and uses almost no resources. I feel that the Mac Mini with Ecamm Live as your switcher app is a great combo and you don't need much else. A camera, an HDMI to USB converter, and a USB mic. You don't need much to have a great minimal live streaming setup. No ATEMs or Rodecasters, as great as that hardware is, but you don't need it to start streaming. The base model M1, I feel would be great for a streaming setup and pair it with an inexpensive 4K monitor. It's a cheaper option than the M1 MacBook Pro and you get a huge monitor. But honestly, I would still recommend the 16 gigs of RAM and at least 512 gigs of SSD to last for the long run. But even the base model will work for just streaming. Overall, the Mac Mini and Ecamm Live is a great streaming combo. If you're interested in catching my live streams, make sure you click the link down below to my dedicated live stream channel where I do deep dives on the craft of photo and video and all things that are related to the creative space. Ultimately, how to fix it in camera and finesse it in post. I'm so glad that you found my channel. As always, thanks for watching. See you next week.